Today sees the release in cinemas of The Many Saints of Newark, a film based on the hit TV show The Sopranos. It centres around a young Anthony Soprano growing up in New Jersey in one of the most tumultuous eras of the state's history. Anthony is played by Michael Gandolfini, the son of the late, great James Gandolfini, and we'll hear from him after this clip.
Hi, Christopher. Hello. Oh, what's the matter? Don't cry. It's only me, Uncle Tony. Oh. What's wrong? Gucci, go.
Oh. Oh.
Okay, all right, all right. You know, every time you hear him, he cries like this.
I didn't do anything.
Oh, what happened? Okay?
Look at that. I don't know what it is. It's like a scam or something.
Some babies, when they come into the world, know all kinds of things from the other side.
And that is a clip from The Many Saints of Newark, available in cinemas across the UK, 22nd of September. Stars Michael Gandolfini, plays the younger version of the iconic Tony Soprano. I'm delighted to say he joins us now. Michael, hello, good afternoon. How are you, sir?
Hello, thank you for taking the time to talk to me.
Well, it's fantastic to have you on. You look as though you're in a hotel room. Where do we find you today?
I'm in my apartment in New York, but I had to keep away from all the walls because I have a bunch of art that wasn't allowed. It's like Johnny Cash flipping the middle finger and things like that. So,
were you told that wasn't allowed?
I was told that might, yeah, not be allowed.
That's one of the most iconic rock and roll photographs of all time.
I love it. It's one of my favorite pictures. Yeah, it's great.
Well, instead of that, we've just got white cupboards and doors. Anyway, it's very nice to have you on the show. The Many Saints of Newark, fascinating film, fascinating story. I'm intrigued as to how this story started with you, how you were approached, how this whole thing began.
I heard about the movie through, Deadline or whatever online, and I just had no sort of, I had been on set as a kid, but I really had no contact with it. I'd never seen the show. I'd see Edie here and there, David rarely, so just thought, well, I'm rooting for them, and then I got asked to audition, and my first response was, I don't think it's right. Not only because of the weight of my dad and kind of wanting to be my own person and my own actor. Also, like, I didn't know Tony Soprano. I didn't know if I could play him. I knew nothing about Tony. So I was a young actor in New York and wasn't really in a position to start saying no to auditions. So I went in to do the best audition I could. And I began watching the first season. And that sort of just started like a natural snowball of, well, then I got a second audition, then a third. And I really began watching the show, getting to know Tony, getting to know how this Tony's different. And really, by the time they said, you have the part, I had spent enough time with Tony to really think, okay, I want to do this. And I'm excited to.
Very early on in that answer, you said, I hadn't seen the show. Is that right? So you hadn't seen The Sopranos?
I'd never seen it before my first audition.
Yeah. So if I've got the maths right, I think you were born when series one happened. You were 8 or 9, right, when the show finished.
Yes.
So how is it possible that you hadn't seen any of the shows? That seems extraordinary.
So like you said, I was too young growing up when it was on. And then my parents both did not let me see it. They did not want me to be associated with it. My dad was just my daddy. He didn't want me to see him as a character. And my parents really, really, really wanted me to live as normal as an upbringing as possible, mowing grass, doing chores, going to school, playing with friends,